वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग, गुड मॉर्निंग परिता, शाश्वत, शुभम एंड तुषार. गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग. कैन यू हियर मी? एवरीथिंग इज फाइन. गुड मॉर्निंग सोविक. गुड मॉर्निंग. We discussed in the previous class relating to leasing, and while discussing I said that earlier relating to leasing there was an IS 17, but the new development is IFRS 16, that is already applicable in ACCA exam in entire 2018. It is actually applicable in ACCA exam since December 2017. December 2017 was the first exam, and then entire 2018 they are testing IFRS 16 only. I said that in CIMA it will be tested from 2019. Up till 2018 they were testing IS 17 only. But now they will be testing 2019 IFRS 16. IS 17 is no more. Then I said that while doing the problems or anything, there is no difference in IS 17 or IFRS 16. But the logic is different. I said that in earlier IS there was operating lease, finance lease. In the new IS there is no name of operating lease or finance lease. In the new IFRS, it is short-term and long-term lease. Then I discussed everything by taking example, not numericals, my own tuition center and other things, how the short-term lease and long-term lease are accounted for by saying some journal entries also. But I said that we will be doing in the next class the numericals in detail so that we will be able to understand. So there is no question coming that in Google you have seen that IFRS 16 is replacing. We discussed that in the class. Okay, Sovik, that we already discussed, and ACCA Institute is already testing. Concentrate. If something, I mean to say, if you are forgetting, then what is that? During the class, sit with a copy or pen and write something if I am saying something which you want to memorize later, so that with your copy you will be able to refer. Okay. Now, any doubt, anybody? Any question, any doubt? Parita, no doubt in EPS? In earnings per share, diluted EPS, basic EPS, anything? And others also? Okay. One second. With the example, with the numericals, you can see completing the leasing chapter, or indirectly, whatever we discussed in the previous class, I am completing that through the numerical examples. The numerical examples I am taking from ACCA F7 books. If suppose Subham will think that maybe why we are not using F2. F2 book you open, then it will be giving you the same thing. It's an IFRS written by Kaplan. So when they want to explain IFRS 16, they will be writing the same thing. on 1st January 2011, Dynamic entered into a two-year lease for a lorry. The contract contains an option to extend the lease term for a further year. Initially, the contract is for 2 years, but the contract contains an option to extend the lease term for further 1 year. So suppose I will say that you are not able to see the question. Others also, nobody can see the slides. Are you all can see the slides? Now I can. Actually, when I show the slides, it will take slightly 10-15 seconds delay. It will not be instantly available at you. When I will be showing, it will be coming after some delay. Okay, don't worry. On 1st January 2011, Dynamic entered into a two-year lease for a lorry. The contract contains an option to extend the lease for a further 1 year. Suppose in my business for transferring study materials at different places to the students or to school colleges, we generally book lorry from outside transport company. For running my business, I purchased the lorry. But I have not purchased it, I have taken it on lease. On 1st January 2011, I have taken a lorry on lease for 2 years. And in the contract, it is written that if I require, I can extend the lease for further 1 year. Dynamic believes that it is reasonably certain to exercise this option. That means 1 year, which is the option, it is 100% sure that certainty that we will be actually extending the lease for one more year. That is, we are going to use the asset for 3 years. Lorries have a useful economic life of 10 years. After 3 years, we need to give back the lorry because we are going to use it for 3 years. The life of lorry is 10 years. So for further 7 years, the owner of the lorry will be doing it something else, maybe giving to somebody else for lease. Lease payments are $10,000 per year for the initial term and $15,000 per year for the option period. So actually for first 2 years, we need to pay $10,000. For the third year, we will be paying $15,000. All payments are due at the end of the year. We will be paying every payment at the end of the year. We are taking on 1st January. So first payment 31st December 2011. Second 31st December 2011. Third 31st December 2011. To obtain the lease, Dynamic incurs indirect cost of 3,000. To obtain the lease, Dynamic incur initial direct cost of 3,000. What can be the direct cost? I don't know, but the direct cost is directly related with the asset. If I will say that, suppose there is some painting done on the lorry to show the permit, or maybe there is some changes done in the lorry internally for our purpose, in that we have incurred 3,000 for using the lorry under the lease. We have incurred certain $3,000 expenditure. This we are not paying to the lesser. We are paying to the lesser 10, 15. This is incurred extra. Whenever you buy an asset, maybe there is some extra expenditure to use the asset. That is treated as direct expenditures. So they are treated as Dynamic incurs initial direct cost of $3,000. The interest rate within the lease is not readily determinable. Dynamic incremental rate of borrowing is 5%. They are saying that the interest rate which is applicable in the lease is not known. Dynamic incremental rate of borrowing 5%. The meaning of these two lines, where in the previous class we were studying I was taking an example. I taken the example that the value of the asset each 50,000. How? I said that we will be paying 15,000, 15,000, 15,000 for 4 years. So we will be paying 50, 50, 15, 60,000. But the cost of the laptop is 50,000. So I said that indirectly, why the person is taking 15, 15, 15, 15, 60,000 when the value of the laptop is 50,000. Then I said that if I will pay now, he will take 50 only. But since I will be paying him in delay, he will charge interest. Maybe it is a lease, but it's actually what? I'm paying the money in installments. Then I said that against 50,000 today, I'm going to pay 15, 15, 15, 15 for 4 times. Then I give the example, if I will deposit 100 today in a bank and the bank is giving me 10% interest, then after 1 year, it will be 110. So 100 is the present value, 110 is the future value. Then I discussed what is the difference between present value, future value, interest. Then I said from 100 to 110, 10% is the interest. No calculator is required. But from 50,000, 15,000, 15,000, 15,000, 15,000 for 4 years, there is a calculator required to calculate the interest. That against 50,000, if it is 15, 15, 15, 15, 4 times, then you require interest calculation. Then I said that in exam, in accounting, F7, they will not ask financial area, which is interest rate calculation. Then I said that maybe suppose the interest rate is 10%. Then I said that for first year, the interest will be 50,000 into 10%, 5,000. We are paying 15,000. So 15 minus 5, balance 10,000 we are paying against principal. So at the end of first year, 50 minus 10, 40,000 principal left. The next year, 40,000 into 10%, 4,000. Again, I am paying 15,000, 15 minus 4, balance 11,000 principal. Maybe the interest rate I have taken different. But I said that I need to divide my payments into interest and principal. Then we discussed journal entries. Journal entries, when you are taking the asset, you are not the owner. You are taking on lease, then it will be treated as right to use the asset to lease liability. That will be 50,000 only, because today the asset value is 50. I will be charging depreciation on the asset value, and on the liability, I will be settling along with interest in 4 years. Then I said that the liability which I am going to settle, it is going to be settled in 4 years. Something I need to pay in a year, something I need to pay beyond a year. The amount which I need to pay within a year will be treated as a current liability. And the amount which I need to pay beyond a year will be treated as a non-current liability. The same thing we are going to discuss 4 or 5 times during current today, along with more detailed examples which are given here. Not taking something from my brain, but using the figures which are exact given in the question. So as I told you, interest rate they will give, they have given. You don't have to calculate, because from 100 to 110, you can calculate 10%. But from 50,000 to 15, 15, 15, 15, you can't calculate interest rate. And actually, they are not asking also. We will be discussing that or studying that in F9 syllabus. For the time being, we are not going into F9 syllabus. We are focusing on F7 syllabus. So the interest rate, each 5% they have given. But they have not given the value of the lorry today. I have given you 50,000 and then 15,000, 15,000, 15,000, 15,000. I said that 50,000 is equal to 15, 15, 15 along with an interest. They have given you that you will be paying 10,000, 15,000, 15,000 for 3 times. The interest rate they are giving 5%. We can find out present value of all these 3 payments. Present value means 100 today, 110 after 1 year. So 100 present value, future value will be 100 into 1 plus interest rate. 100 into 1.1 will give you 110. But 110 future value, present value is 110 divided by 1.1. For calculating future value, will need to multiply with 1 plus interest rate. For calculating present value, we need to divide by 1 plus interest rate. And we discussed the example 6 monthly, not 1 year. I said that the lease payment is 15, 15, 15 every 6 month. So if it is 1 year, you are taking 1 plus interest rate to the power 1. But if it is half 6 months, you will be taking 1 plus interest rate to the power 0.5. If it is 1 month, you will be taking 1 plus interest rate to the power 1 by 12. But those types of calculations will not be involved. Just that I discussed that. 10,000 ek saal baad hai. Interest rate 5%. 10,000 each future value. Interest rate is 5%. How can we calculate present value of 10,000? 10,000 is after 1 year. 5% is the interest rate. How can we calculate present value of 10,000 today? 10,000 is after 1 year. Interest rate is 5%. How can we calculate present value of 10,000 today? You don't have to do to the power 1 because power 1 to rehta hi hai na sabhi bhi. Koi baat nahi hai. Hum log bol rahe hain ki future value kaise nikalna hai. Jo aaj ki value hai usko 1 plus interest rate se multiply karna hai. To agar future value hai to present value kaise nikalna hai. Jo future ki value hai usko 1 plus interest rate se divide dena hai. Everybody is getting or not, because only Subham said, Parita, everybody. If you are not getting, please tell me. There is no issue. बट आपको कैलकुलेशन लिखना होगा क्लास में. सो 10,000 प्रेजेंट वैल्यू इज 10,000 बाय 1.05. बट द सेकंड इज 10,000 सेकंड ईयर. देन व्हाट विल बी द प्रेजेंट वैल्यू ऑफ सेकंड 10,000? व्हाट विल बी द प्रेजेंट वैल्यू ऑफ सेकंड 10,000? फर्स्ट 10,000, 10,000 बाय 1.05. द सेकंड 10,000 इज 2 ईयर लेटर. So what is the present value of second 10,000? 10,000 by 1.05 square. Then the third is 15,000. So what is the present value of 15,000? The third payment will be 15,000. What will be the present value of the third payment? 15,000 by 1.05 cube. So what will be the total present value of all the payments? 10,000 by 1.05 plus 10,000 by 1.05 square plus 15,000 by 1.05 cube. That will be the present value of all the three payments. In exam, if you don't want to do like this, if you go in the discounting table, in every exam they will give the table. In the table, there will be in the columns interest rate, 5% interest rate, in the rows 1 year, 2 year, 3 year. So whatever you will get 1 by 1.05, that is written in the table. Whatever you will do 1 by 1.05 square, that will be in the table. For first 10,000, what we are doing? 10,000 by 1.05. I can say 10,000 into 1 by 1.05. So in the table, 1 by 1.05 value is given. You can use the table and multiply with first 10,000. You can use the table, the second figure, multiply with the second 10,000. You can use the table, the third figure, multiply with 15,000. But when you use the table, slightly the figure will be different than if you do from the calculator. Both are correct. Because 1 by 1.05 is not an exact figure. It is in huge decimals. In table, they write 3 decimal places. That is called discounting factor table. Anybody can use the table also. Anybody can use the calculator also. It's upon you. There is no hard and fast rule that you are bound to use the table. But by using the table, the calculation can be fast. If you check the table in 5% column, in front of 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, 3 figures are given. You will say 10,000 into first year, first figure, plus 10,000 into second figure, plus 15,000 into third figure. You can do with the calculator, you can use the table. Both are allowed. Slightly the figure will be different. But still, for the time being, if we are using the calculator, can anybody tell me what is the total present value? 10,000 divided by 1.05 plus 10,000 divided by 1.05 square plus 15,000 divided by 1.05 cube. 10,000 divided by 1.05 plus 10,000 divided by 1.05 square plus 15,000 divided by 1.05 cube. Please don't say wrong. In my example, in the last class, I said 50,000 is the present value. And 15,000, we will pay 6 monthly basis. In this example, 31,552 is the present value. And we are going to pay 10,000, 15,000. 10 plus 10, 20, 20 plus 15, 35,000. The present value is 31,552. But you are making a total payment of 35,000. The present value is 31,552. But you are making a total payment of 35,000. We are not using the decimal. Rounded off 31 because it will take 10, give you 10 cents. The present value is 31,552. And we are going to make payment of 35,000. What is the difference? I'm not asking the figure. What we can say as a difference? 31,552 is the present value. And we are going to pay 10,000, 10,000 and 15,000. So what is the difference? That is the interest. You assume that suppose you are taking loan for purchasing the asset, for purchasing the lorry. You are taking a loan of 31,552. When you take a loan, you have to pay interest. When you borrow, you have to pay interest. Against 31,552, when you will be making payment in 3 years, you need to pay interest for 3 years. Interest dena padega. The accounting body of the world realized that this is this only. Even though we have not borrowed, but accounting body says that if you borrow and purchase the assets and then you will be using the asset for your purpose, when you are going in the lease, you are doing the same thing. Because maybe you cannot say that you are the owner because it is on lease, but you are using the asset just like you would have purchased. I am using my tuition center. Anything I can do the way I would have done if I would have purchased. So lease is treated as borrowing only. So when you borrow and purchase the asset will be there in the balance sheet and borrowed amount will be there in the liability. So when you are going for leasing, asset will be there in the balance sheet and the liability will be there in the liability. Lease is just like borrowing and purchasing the asset. But the leased asset, you are not the owner. So you will be writing in your balance sheet, not the asset. You will be writing in your balance sheet, right to use the asset. We will be writing in our financial statement, right to use the asset. If you borrow and then purchase the asset, if you borrow, journal entry will be bank account debit to loan. Then you use the amount to purchase the asset. Journal entry will be asset account debit to bank. So money gone. Ultimately, what is the net effect? asset account debit to loan. When you are going for leasing, the same journal entry. In place of asset, right to use the asset account debit to lease liability. Right to use the asset account debit to lease liability. Why? Because we are not the owner. The legal document does not say that we are the owner. But the accounting body consider that you are the owner. You are not writing the name of the asset. You are writing right to use the asset. What will be the value? 31,552. It is not 35,000. Because 35,000 includes the interest. You cannot debit the asset with the interest amount. Interest will be debited in PL account. Asset will be debited with the asset value. So the journal entry, just like a loan and purchase the asset, right to use the asset account debit to lease liability. 31,552. So if that is not given, you are bound to calculate like we have calculated. They have given you the payments. Those payments, you find out the present value, you exclude the interest, you will get the value of the asset. So that is called right to use the asset account debit to lease liability. Don't try to mug up this. It's a purely very good concept which the whole world understand. We also need to understand. There is nothing mug up required. Maybe there are 5,000 problems. Understand the problem with basics. So if you do 4 or 5 problems, you will be able to solve every. But if you are just mugging up, even after doing 50 problems, the next one you will not be able to do. So don't do only numerical calculation. Understand the concept behind the numericals. So when we have calculated the present value, the journal entry will be right to use the asset account debit to lease liability. 31,552. This entry we are passing on 1st January 2011. We took the asset on lease, we passed the journal entry. So in our balance sheet, asset is there. In our balance sheet, lease liability is there. But we will prepare balance sheet at the end of the year, 31st December 2011. So for the year, there will be an interest. The interest will be calculated on 31,552 at the rate of 5%, which is given. And you have already calculated present value with 5%. So on 31,552 at the rate of 5%, what will be the first year interest? On 31,552 at the rate of 5%, what will be the first year interest? Rounded off, no decimals. 31,552 at the rate of 5% is coming 1,578. Interest is an expenditure. It is not an asset. So interest account debit to lease liability. We will pay interest. We have not yet paid. We are passing the due entry. Interest account debit credited lease liability. That interest will be transferred to PL. Profit and loss account debit to interest. But the lease liability becomes how much? 31,552 plus 1,578. 31,552 plus 1,578. Now at the end of first year, you are making payment of 10,000. At the end of first year, after doing the interest entry, you are passing the entry for payment. That is lease liability account debit to bank 10,000. So on 31st December 2011, you are increasing the lease liability by the interest amount. And on 31st December, when you are making payment of 10,000, you are reducing the lease liability by 10,000. Actually, we are saying that we are paying interest of 1,578 and the balance we are paying against principal. We are paying the interest of 1,578 first year, 10,000 minus 1,578, we are paying the balance against the principal. Because in the loan, you need to pay along with interest principal also. If you only pay the interest, then the principal will never finish. So you are paying 10,000 first year. Out of that 10,000, 1,578 is the interest and the balance is the principal. So what I did, 31,552 was the original value. I've added 1,578 and then I've deducted 10,000 with the journal entry. Interest account debit to lease liability, 1,578. Then lease liability account debit to bank, 10,000. So what is the lease liability balance at the end of first year? What will be the lease liability balance at the end of first year? What will be the lease liability balance at the end of first year? It is 31,552 plus 1,578 minus 10,000. So first year interest you have paid and some principal you have paid. Interest gone to PL, the liability is reduced. 31st December 2011 is over. Now we are in 2012. That is 31st December 2012 because entire year there is nothing. Again on 23,130 at the rate of 5% second year interest. 23,130 at the rate of 5% second year interest. Why the interest is lower than the first year? Last year it was more, current year it is less. Why? 23,130 into 5%. Why it is lower than first year? Why the interest is lower than the last year? When you pay the loan principal, the loan amount will reduce. When you have paid the principal, you have to pay lower interest. आप अगर लोन लोगे और कुछ पैसा चुका दोगे तो आपको तो इंटरेस्ट कमती पे ही देना पड़ेगा ना. तो आपने पहला साल कुछ प्रिंसिपल चुका दिया तो दूसरे साल इंटरेस्ट कम लगेगा, विच इज लॉजिकल. द एंट्री फॉर सेकेंड ईयर इंटरेस्ट विल बी इंटरेस्ट अकाउंट डेबिट टू लीज लाइबिलिटी 1157. Interest will be debited to PL account. So profit and loss account debit to interest gone. The lease liability is 23,130 plus 1,157. Again you pay second year and 10,000. So lease liability account debit to bank 10,000 second installment gone. So the second year end after making payment of 10,000, what is the balance? 23,130 plus 1157 minus 10,000. 23,130 plus 1157 minus 10,000. It is 14,287. Second year is over. Now we are going into the last year. On 14,287, at the rate of 5%, the last year interest. On 14,287, at the rate of 5%, the last year interest. If you add 14,287 plus 714, how much it will come? Because interest entry will be interest account debit to lease liability. 14,287 plus 714, how much it will come? It will not exactly come 15,000. It will always be slightly difference. The difference is not because of anything. It is just an approximation error. When you have calculated present value of 10,000 by 1.05, 10,000 by 1.05 square, 15,000 by 1.05 cube, Saswat said that it is coming 0.67. But we have not taken 0.67. So there is some approximation error. If there would not be any approximation error, then along with interest, it should be coming 15,000 only. So third year, we don't calculate interest. Whatever is the amount left at the beginning of third year, we compare with 15,000 and we will consider balance amount as interest only. Otherwise, the whole thing will not tally. In the last year, don't calculate interest. Interest will be the balancing figure. Whatever is the due amount at the beginning, whatever you are paying the last installment, 15,000, balance is the interest. It is slightly $1-$2 or in a bigger amount, it will be $500, $1,000 will be different. The interest entry will be interest account debit to lease liability. So lease liability will become 15,000. You will pay lease liability to bank 15,000. At the end of third year, full payment is done. The liability is over. Jaise aap loan chukate, वैसे आपने लीज का पैसा चुका दिया. जो आपका एसेट्स है 31,552 एसेट साइड में है, दैट इज गोइंग टू बी यूज फॉर 3 years. सो यू विल बी चार्जिंग डेप्रिसिएशन फॉर 3 years. 31,552 डिवाइडेड बाई 3. जर्नल एंट्री एवरी ईयर विल बी डेप्रिसिएशन अकाउंट डेबिट टू एक्यूमुलेटेड डेप्रिसिएशन फर्स्ट ईयर. 31,552 बाई 3. दैट डेप्रिसिएशन विल बी डेबिटेड टू पीएल अकाउंट. Profit and loss account debit to depreciation. So in the books, accumulated depreciation will be there. So first year value of assets will be 31,552 minus the accumulated depreciation of first year. Second year, Again, the journal entry depreciation account debit to accumulated depreciation. Second year depreciation will also be transferred to PN. Profit and loss account debit to depreciation. But second year, the accumulated depreciation is double. First year plus second year. So the asset value in the balance sheet, that is the original cost minus 2 years accumulated depreciation. Third year, the last accumulated depreciation. Depreciation to accumulated depreciation. Depreciation transferred to PL. Now third year, the total accumulated depreciation is 31,552. So 31,552 minus 31,552, fully asset gone. So at the end of third year, asset is given to the lessor. Liability is paid, asset gone, liability paid, and dance. That's the story. With the calculation, you need to pass the journal entries. You need to think the ledger. You need to think about PL account and balance sheet. Sorry, I forgot to cast the and record the entry for 3000. Good, thank you, Parita. Thank you. Nobody has said this. Actually, the assets value will be treated as 31,552 plus 3000. If I will purchase this laptop and to use this laptop, I need to do some changes, then that is treated as part of the asset only. So the asset value will be 31,552 plus 3000. When I purchase the asset on 1st January on lease, then I will pass journal entry, right to use the asset account debit to cash 3000 further. Right to use the asset account debit to lease liability 31,552. And right to use the asset account debit to cash 3000. So the asset value is 34,552. So you will be charging depreciation on 34,552 for 3 years, not on 31,352. By mistake, I forgot that. आप कोई भी एसेट्स खरीदोगे उसको यूज करने के लिए आपको कुछ खर्चा करना पड़ेगा तो वो एसेट का वैल्यू ही माना जाता है. सो यू विल बी डेबिटिंग अंडर राइट टू यूज द एसेट ओनली. बट दैट इज नॉट यू आर पेइंग इन 3 years, यू आर पेइंग नाउ ओनली. सो इट विल बी डेबिटेड इन द एसेट एंड द कैश इज गॉन. सो राइट टू यूज द एसेट टू कैश. Is there any problem in anybody's mind? Whatever I have said up till now, believe me, whether you do 5,000 problems, in every problem, the figures will be different. If your concept is clear, you need to study less. But if you just think that doing the problems, seeing the answers, not trying on your own, never the concept and never the confidence will be coming. We are in the initial classes. We did EPS, but you will realize that if you don't study properly for further 2-3 classes in a week or two only, you will find that you are missing the hit target. So don't do that. Do the questions in writing. Answers are not written at the back just to see. In your own writing, some questions should be done. While doing the problems, think about concept, not just numericals, present value, future value and all that. Think why you are doing that. Go in deep in doing the problems. Then in that case, you don't have to revise. It will be there in your brain forever. And while doing the chapter, make some notes. Do some notes. When you do some noting, then later on you don't have to do the video and all that. Your notes will be enough to help you. Whatever I have said up till now, is there any question in journal entry, in calculations, in anywhere? Please ask. Now, whatever I have said, I have not said 100% correct. Slightly, the things are still left. In the balance sheet, when we prepare liability side, the liability side has shareholders' funds, share capital, reserves and all that. The liability side has outsiders' fund. Outsider are divided into two parts. Non-current liability, current liability. Non-current liability means those liability which the organization need to pay beyond 1 year. And current liabilities are those liabilities which the organization need to pay within a year. If we will be preparing the balance sheet for first year, 31st December 2011, 1st January is our year starting. So we will be preparing balance sheet on 31st December 2011. On 31st December 2011, what was the lease liability we discussed? At the end of first year, what was the lease liability we discussed? At the end of first year, what was the lease liability we discussed? The total balance of lease liability. Anybody remembers? Everybody has written the figure. मेरे को याद है क्योंकि मैं केवल फिगर पे कैलकुलेशन पे ध्यान नहीं दे रहा हूं, दिमाग पूरा जोर से लगा रहा हूं. डू एवरीबॉडी रिमेंबर इट वाज 23,130. कितना सुंदर से पढ़ रहे हैं उस पे ये दिमाग पड़ता है. फिगर्स तो हर समय अलग अलग ही होगा. दिस 23,130 इज व्हाट? 31,552 प्लस द फर्स्ट ईयर इंटरेस्ट माइनस 10,000 फर्स्ट ईयर पेमेंट. That is 23,130. At the end of 31st December 2011, outstanding was 23,130. In how many years we will be paying this? 23,130. In how many years we will be paying this? In 2 years, in 2012 and 2013. This 23,130 does include any interest? This 23,130 does include any interest? This 23,130 does include any interest? Parita is saying yes, Saswat is saying no, but others. The amount outstanding at the end of first year, 23,130, does include any interest? Parita, when we take the loan, does it include interest? Interest will be included when the period will be over, when the due date will be over. And that too, when you don't pay. Aap loan agar lego, loan hai. आप इंटरेस्ट का अमाउंट जब पे करना है पे कर दोगे तो इंटरेस्ट कैसे रहेगा? तो आपने 31,552 पे इंटरेस्ट फर्स्ट ईयर का जोड़ा, लेकिन आपने तो 10,000 जो पे किया उसमें फर्स्ट ईयर का इंटरेस्ट और बैलेंस प्रिंसिपल पे कर दिया, तो 23,130 के अंदर इंटरेस्ट कैसे आया? द फर्स्ट ईयर इंटरेस्ट वॉज 1587 something. वी पेड 1587 एंड द प्रिंसिपल. So how come the 23,130 includes interest? When the interest is due and you are not paying, then the liability will include interest. But when the interest is due and you are making payment, how come it includes interest? That 23,130 includes second and third year interest. First year ka to nahi hai. Does 23,130 include second and third year interest? यानी कि आज अगर लोन लेंगे 10 साल के लिए तो सारा इंटरेस्ट का एंट्री आज ही मार देंगे. आज अगर मैं बैंक से बोरो करूंगा $1,00,000, मेरे को 10 साल में चुकाना है, तो 10 साल का जो इंटरेस्ट है वो आज ही लिख देंगे. ऐसा होता है क्या कि जिस साल जब इंटरेस्ट आएगा तब लिखेंगे? व्हेन वी डिस्कस द इंटरेस्ट एंट्री, देन वी डिस्कस फॉर सेकेंड ईयर सेपरेट एंट्री एट द एंड ऑफ सेकेंड ईयर, वी डिस्कस फॉर थर्ड ईयर सेपरेट एंट्री एट द एंड ऑफ थर्ड ईयर. We have not discussed that we pass all the interest entry at the beginning of the loan only. So, kya 23,130 ki andar second year, third year ka interest hai kya? 23,130 due at the end of first year, does it include any interest? It does not include first year interest also because it is paid. It cannot include second and third year interest because it is not due. Without interest being due, how can you pass the entry for interest? Interest ka entry aap tabhi karenge jab wo due hoga. Ye sab baat believe kariye, jab sum karte hain sochte hi nahi hai. Lekin har ek cheez jitne sundar tarike se soche jayegi utna nikhar kar aayenge. Usse koi matlab nahi hai. Saswat will say that I am a bad student earlier. Parita will say that I am a bad student. What's the question of your bad or good? That was past. We are discussing everything in 100% detail. So your bad or good with the past doesn't have any meaning. If you are ready to become good, you will be the best person to pass the exam. लेकिन आपको मेरा सुनना होएगा, मैं जो बोल रहा हूं वैसे आपको पढ़ाई करनी होगी, आप नहीं करेंगे तो गड़बड़ होएगा. So there is 23,130 does not include any interest. It is only 31,552 का principal portion जो बाकी है. 23,130 you will be paying in 2 years. So some amount you will pay in 2012 and some amount you will pay in 2013. You are standing at 31st December 2011. We are standing at 31st December 2011. Some amount principal we will pay in 31st December 2012 and balance amount we will pay in 31st December 2013. I will be showing in the balance sheet 23,130. No question. But 23,130 will be divided into two parts. The amount which is payable in 2012 will be treated as current liability. Why? Because that is payable within 1 year. And the amount which is payable in 2013 will be treated as non-current liability because it is payable beyond 1 year. When you are standing at 2011 December, then whatever you pay within 12 December, it is current liability. Whatever you pay beyond 12 December, it is non-current liability. So 23,130 will be there in the balance sheet. But out of 23,130, there is two division. Payable in a year, current liability. Payable beyond a year, non-current liability. How much will be the figure? That is secondary matter. But understanding is the primary matter. So when we will be standing at 2012 end, 1 year further over, when we will be standing at 2012 end, then we will have only current liability in this example. Why? Because everything we will pay within 2013. There is no payment in 14. So at the end of first year, there is current, non-current both. But at the end of second year, there is only current, nothing non-current. Are you understanding this concept? The accounting principle says that whatever you need to pay within a year is a current liability. Whatever you need to pay beyond 1 year is a non-current liability. So at the end of first year, there is current and non-current. But at the end of second year, in this example, there is only current. But the liability will be only of principal, not of interest. Interest will become the liability when you are not paying. When you are paying the interest, why the interest will become liability? But this, in place of saying you again and again, I am showing you the calculations which we have discussed. From that calculation only, you will be getting that. Don't panic. I am changing the pages, slides. Once it is a stick, you will be able to see. Aap tension mat lijiye. The lease term is 3 years. Sorry, one second. Maybe you have not yet seen up till now. Can you all see the screen? The lease term is 3 years. This is because the option to extend the lease is reasonably certain. If they would have not written reasonably certain, we would be considering lease term is 2 years. Hum log ko kya malum ki third year lease pe jayenge ki nahin? But in question, it is mentioned that it is reasonably certain. Ye 100% hai ki hum log 3 saal ka lease lenge. So for that reason, they are saying 3 years. The lease liability is calculated as follows. 10,000 ka present value. 10,000 into 1 by 1.05. You can see the table, discounting factor table, where 1 by 1.05 figure will be given. So you multiply 10,000 into that figure. Or you can do in calculator like we have done. 10,000 by 1.05. then second one, then third one. All is coming 31,552. The initial cost of the right to use the asset 3,000 जोड़कर आप lesser को pay करेंगे 31,552 और 3,000 आपने शुरू में asset को change करने में किया है. So journal entry is right to use the asset account debit to lease liability, right to use the asset account debit to cash. We can pass one entry at a time. Right to use the asset account debit 34,552 to lease liability 31,552 to cash 3,000. We discussed current non-current liability, but maybe in this question they have not asked. So I am not discussing the figures now of this question. I will be discussing the figures of this question, current and non-current, after 5-7 minutes, which I will be asking from you. Can you all see the test your understanding one? Can you all see the test your understanding one? It is written calculate the initial carrying amount of the lease liability, which is 31,552. Right to use the asset 34,552 plus 3,000 and provide the double entries, record these transactions. So they have not asked the journal entries for interest and payment. They have only asked the first journal entry. What will be the liability, what will be the asset value, and what will be the journal entry. But we will be coming into that. Ek example unhone solve karke diya hai. Pehle isko kar rahe hain, fir uske baad us question mein fir se jayenge. Can you all see it? Illustration one. Can you all see the illustration one? Thank you. R enters into an agreement to lease an asset. The terms of the lease are as follows. Primary period is for 4 years from 1st January 2012 with a rental of $2,000 per annum on 31st December each year. Primary period is for 4 years from 1st January with a rental of $2,000 per annum on 31st December. The question arises that what is primary period? In the previous example, the primary period was 2 years. The secondary period was 1 year. We considered both the period for the calculations because it was written that it was certain that we will be going for secondary period. Generally, that language is not written in most of the problems. So we do the problem only for primary period. We don't consider secondary period unless and until it is certain. They are saying that primary period is 4 year. In that problem, it was 2 year. 1st January 2012. Rental of 2000 per annum on 31st December each year. So we will be paying 2000, 2000, 2000 for 4 years. The present value of lease payments is 5710. In the previous question, we calculated present value 10,000, 10,000, 15,000. The present value was 33,152. In this, they are doing the present value calculation 5710. You don't have to do, which is 2000, 2000, 2000. Total is 8,000. Present value is 5710. So balance 8,000 minus 5710 is the interest. The interest rate implicit in the lease is 15%. In the previous question, the interest rate was 5%. In this question, the interest rate is 15%. So the calculation is less. What figures will be shown in the financial statement for the year ended 31st December 2012? So they are saying that at the end of first year, when you will prepare the balance sheet, what will be shown in the balance sheet, asset side, liability side? They are saying that the present value is 5710. That is the right to use the asset. Then they are saying that we will be using the asset for 4 years. So 5710 by 4 will be the depreciation every year. Then they are saying that 5710 is the initial lease liability. Then they started calculating the interest. At first year beginning, 5710 is due. 15% 857 is the interest. So 5710 plus 857 at the end of first year. But you paid 2000. So 5710 plus 857 minus 2000. The first year end due. This 4567, whether includes interest or not. At the end of first year, 4567, whether it includes interest or not. Because the first year interest is already paid. And the second year, third year, fourth year interest is not due. How can it be included? Like 23,310, this is 4567. Now this becomes second year opening outstanding. At the rate of 15% on this, there is an interest. You paid 2000. So the closing outstanding, this plus this minus 2000, 3252. Again, this 3252 does not include interest. Because the second year interest is already paid. And third and fourth year interest is not due. Then this becomes third year opening balance plus 15% interest minus 2000. Third year closing balance again principal. This 1740 fourth year opening balance. If you calculate 15%, it will not be coming exactly 260. But I said that in the last year, you consider interest as a balancing figure. You are paying 2000, 1740 each principal, 260 is the interest. Now at the end of first year, I will be showing in the balance sheet 4567 total liability. At the end of first year, I will be showing in the balance sheet 4567 total liability. But I need to divide that into two parts. Current liability, non-current liability. Out of 4567, which is due at the end of 2012, whatever we will be paying in 2013 will be current liability. And whatever we will be paying beyond 2013 will be non-current liability. Whatever we will be paying in 2013 will be current liability. And whatever we will be paying beyond 2013 will be non-current liability. Parita, will you pay 3252 in 2013 or at the end of 2013 it is still due? In 2013, will you pay 3252 you are paying or after 2013 it is still due? Ye 2012 ke end mein due hai. Ye 2013 ke end mein due hai. So 3252 to aap pay 2013 mein nahi karoge. To aap pay kitna karoge? 4567 minus 3252. So 4567 minus 3252 is a current liability. And 3252 is a non-current liability. Ultimately 1315 plus 3252 dono mila ke 4567 hi hai. Ultimately 1315 plus 3252 is 4567 only. But you need to show in the balance sheet current and non-current. To aap agar next year ka total due nikal loge, उसमें से फर्स्ट ईयर में से लेस कर दोगे तो करंट आ जाएगा और जो नेक्स्ट ईयर का है वो नॉन करंट हो जाएगा. तो वैसे ही 2013 में करंट नॉन करंट कितना होगा? इन 2013 क्लोजिंग बैलेंस शीट व्हाट विल बी द करंट नॉन करंट? इन 2013 क्लोजिंग बैलेंस शीट व्हाट विल बी द करंट नॉन करंट? 3252 माइनस 1740 इज करंट and 1740 is non-current. 3252 minus 1740 is current and 1740 is non-current. In 2014 and what will be the current non-current? In 2014 and what will be the current non-current? You say current liability will be 1740, non-current is zero. Don't say nil. In 2014 and you will pay 1740 in 1 year. There is nothing you need to pay beyond 1 year. So current liability is 1740. Now they are saying that extract at 31st December. Depreciation in the PL account. Finance cost for the first year in PL account. In balance sheet, write to use the asset. Cost of the asset minus first year depreciation. In balance sheet, non-current 3252. In balance sheet, current 1315. You are showing 4355 something. But that need to be divided into two parts. Whatever is payable within 1 year is current liability. Whatever is payable beyond 1 year is non-current liability. is everybody is getting the entire story finished. Present value calculation, why we do that, why we sow assets, why we sow liability, how to do the calculations and everything. Believe me, विद्या हाथ में और मेरा 30 साल का एक्सपीरियंस बोल रहा हूं, आपको समझ में आया है? लेकिन आप ये वाला करे बगैर दूसरा क्वेश्चन करने लग जाएंगे, गड़बड़ होगा. When the class is over, you need to do this question again in writing. Don't see the figures. जब क्लास में समझ गए तो देखना क्यों है? Do that in your own writing, in your book, in your copy. You will become cut piece masterpiece. But if you don't read this and you start doing the new problem, you will become very bad student. The thing is not that when it is understood in the class, you start doing the new problem. Whatever is done in the class, you need to do it again. Don't do Google search first. First of all, do that, whatever is done in the class. When in the class, everybody is saying, yes, 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 no issue. Why we are not doing that again after the class is over? Why? Please request. Aap apne tarike se padh chuke, mere baar mere tarah se padhiye. एक बार केवल जीवन में, वन टाइम. शाश्वत, सोविक, परिता, तुसार, एवरीबडी प्लीज स्टडी द वे आई एम सेइंग. व्हेन द क्लास इज ओवर, यू आर अंडरस्टैंडिंग इन द क्लास, डू दोस प्रॉब्लम्स अगेन, देन यू कैन ट्राई द न्यू प्रॉब्लम्स. डोंट ट्राई द न्यू प्रॉब्लम्स बिफोर डूइंग द व्हाट एवर इज डन इन द क्लास. बिकॉज आपने समझा, टेस्ट तो करिए कि क्लास के बाद जब मैं नहीं हूं तो आपको क्या समझ में आता है क्या? 99% स्टूडेंट से नहीं होगा. यू आर नॉट बैड, डेफिनेटली यू विल फॉरगेट समथिंग. मैं भी आपके जगह होता ऐसा ही होता. लेकिन आप सीधा क्वेश्चंस करने लग जाएंगे दूसरा, एंड देन यू विल से दैट आई एम नॉट एबल टू सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम. इट विल बी हैपनिंग एवरी टाइम इन लाइफ. दैट प्रॉब्लम विल नॉट अराइज व्हेन यू डू दैट व्हिच इज ऑलरेडी डन इन द क्लास. परिता फॉर यू, व्हेन यू सेड इन द फर्स्ट क्लास आई एम नॉट एबल टू सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम, बिकॉज व्हेन यू डिड द क्लास, you have not done that on your own again after the class. Everybody, it's a request. Haath jodkar binti hai. Aur jab aap karenge, apna notes banayenge. So that you don't have to see recording, don't have to read the book, your notes are ready. Don't see my notes. Apna khud ka understanding. Us din se kabhi jeevan mein takleef nahi hogi koi topic mein. Believe me, this is my understanding of 30 years. मैं इस क्वेश्चन का डेटा में नहीं जा रहा हूं, बिकॉज यू हैव अंडरस्टूड. दूसरे क्वेश्चन का डेटा में जाएंगे. इन दिस चैप्टर द कैलकुलेशंस आर आल्सो देयर, कॉन्सेप्ट इज आल्सो देयर. दोनों चीज का मिक्सचर है. दिस क्वेश्चन फॉलोज ऑन फ्रॉम द प्रीवियस टीयूआई, दैट इज दिस 2000-2001. प्रिपेयर एक्सट्रैक्ट फ्रॉम डी फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट इन रेस्पेक्ट ऑफ लीज एग्रीमेंट for the year ended 31st December 2011. क्या करना है? What they are asking? Prepare extracts from Dynamics financial statement in respect of lease agreement for the year ended 31st December 2011. What they are asking in the question? I'm not asking the answer. I'm asking what they are asking. मेरे को नहीं समझ में आ रहा है. Subham, can you say? Others are not doing the recording of the earlier batch. In the first two classes only this has been said. And Subham, you have studied in F1. There is an IAS called IAS 8. Changes in policies, estimates and errors. In that IAS, it is said that if there is any transaction because of which there is a change in policy or anything, you need to disclose in notes to accounts. ये कोई change in policy नहीं है, लेकिन company अगर lease पे assets लेती है, तो company को notes to accounts में ये बताना होगा कि ये पूरा agreement में है क्या? कि हम लोगों ने एक एसेट्स लीज पे लिया है 4 इयर्स के लिए, कॉन्ट्रैक्ट है कि हम लोग 2000 हर साल पे करेंगे और हम लोग एसेट्स को 4 इयर्स यूज करेंगे, हम लोग के पास लीज ऑप्शन है, हम लोग उस ओनर नहीं है उस एसेट्स के, हम लोगों को उसका पेमेंट 4 साल के अंदर करना है, हमने बैलेंस शीट में वो एसेट्स का लाइबिलिटी ऐसे कैलकुलेट किया है, इंटरेस्ट रेट 15% पकड़ा है, आपको अपने लैंग्वेज में लिखना है एग्रीमेंट का बात को, नोट्स टू अकाउंट्स में बताना होगा। व्हाई? जस्ट बाय लुकिंग एट पीएल अकाउंट एंड बैलेंस शीट पीपल विल नॉट अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इज डूइंग। सो इफ यू डोंट एक्सप्लेन इन द नोट्स टू अकाउंट्स देन हाउ एनीबॉडी विल अंडरस्टैंड? अ नॉलेजेबल पर्सन डोंट सी द पीएल एंड बैलेंस शीट, अ नॉलेजेबल पर्सन विल सी द नोट्स टू अकाउंट्स, बिकॉज इन द नोट्स टू अकाउंट एवरीथिंग इज मेंशनड, all ghaplas, all window dressing, everything is mentioned because you are bound to mention that in the notes to accounts. So in your own language you need to explain the entire facts in notes to accounts. aap bolenge sir wo log to bahut badhiya likhi hai, sir aapko apna aata hai na, aapko likhna hai, unko likhne dijiye. You need to explain that the total lease agreement in the notes to accounts and relating to that what is the due amount that you need to mention, that you will be paying in 4 years, at the end of 1 year you need to pay this, beyond 1 year you will be paying this, so this becomes current non current liability. Pura batana hoga. When you will, the class is over, you will be writing in your own sentences, don't see their answer, then read what they have written, and if you find that there is some issue then I am there. But unka english aur aapka english same nahi hoga, mera english aur aapka english same nahi hoga, aapko keval likhna hai agreement ka facts. That is requirement of IFRS 16 only. IFRS 16 का requirement है कि if you are taking any asset on lease, then the entire agreement, what you need to pay in how many years, that need to be mentioned in the notes to accounts. English is a funny language. Whatever you want to write. Getting my point? We discussed in the previous class long term short term lease. I said that in a short term lease there is no interest and all that. Short term lease is a rent. You will pay rent, you will debit in PL account. There is no liability, there is no asset. Earlier it is said as operating lease, but now there is no concept of operating or financial lease. Short term lease is that lease where the period is less than 12 months. Or the short term lease is that lease which is for a very small value of assets. Maybe the period is greater than 12 months, but if the value of assets is very small, it will be treated as short term. Now, what is the value of the asset? They have not stated. But generally, the low value asset, they are giving examples. Table, small furnitures, telephone, small personal computers. This is not exhaustive list. They are saying that these can be treated as low value assets. Maybe you are taking these assets on lease for greater than 12 months. It will be treated as short term lease. They are saying that for, you can say, exam purpose or general term, if the value of assets is within $5,000, we can say that it is a low value assets. Relating to period, it is mentioning less than 12 months. But relating to value, IFRS does not mention anything. It just give examples of certain assets. Tablets, a small personal computer, a telephone, small items of furniture, they can be treated as a small value assets. If they are taking on lease, there is no asset, there is no liability. Whatever lease rent you are paying, that is an expense. जैसे कोई सामान भाड़े पे लेते हैं, can you see the illustration to low value assets? Can you see the illustration to low value assets? On 1st April 2016, T acquires telephones just as an example. I am saying generally you see that today is holiday in entire India, 25th December, but the number of students who are doing the live class are less than those who attend on a normal day. So generally the student says that ki my office is there, can you keep the class on Saturday, Sunday? But I have seen that the presentation is very less in Saturday, Sunday. It is better in weekdays. Second thing, generally since I am going into fourth class, you will find that after one or two classes, only one or two students will be doing live. All are gone. जो कि normal है. शुरू में सब आते हैं, बाद में सब गायब हो जाते हैं. सब मतलब in the initial one or two classes, more than 50% join live. After 3, 4, 5 classes, everybody go out. Only one or two students do the live class. And it's not that the classes are during office hours. The classes are always beyond office hours. If you do the live class, understanding will be better. Why? Because your juice to do the live class will always be better than doing the recorded class. But obviously, why the recording is required? For revision, for pausing the video, for hearing the same thing again and again, for making your notes, that is also required. I'm not questioning that. But if you always attend the live class, your understanding will be at a higher level. Otherwise, why require live class? When everything is taught earlier, why to teach again? I always wanted that. And if in any live class, there is something which is taught better, I am including that. Like the previous class, I thought that it was taught in a better way. So I have included that as a 9A. You must have seen the Excel sheet. 9A maine add kar diya hai. वैसे ये वाली क्लास भी 9B बोलकर ऐड करूंगा. 9 is already there leasing. I have added 9A and 9B, this one I will be adding. Because यहां पर हम लोग जो डिस्कस कर रहे हैं, हो सकता है पिछले बार थोड़ा कम थे डिस्कस किए थे, लेकिन आपको जो शुरू में 1, 2, 3, 4 क्लासेस है उसमें कोई चेंजेस 20 साल से नहीं है, वो वैसे ही है. तो आपको तो एक टारगेट लेकर चलना होगा ना कि मेरे को हर वीक 2 रिकॉर्डिंग करना है, सो दैट I will be able to complete 34 classes. Otherwise, how I will complete? Which I mailed you also. Ki aapko ek proper target lekar study karna hoga. You may think that March is very long. Baki hai. Pata nahi chalega time kaise beet jayega. Along with live, along with recording, you need to keep a target. You need to study properly. You need to revise the stuff which is done earlier regularly. Then you will be getting the confidence. One subject, why can't we score 100 out of 100? Why I will be getting 50-55? That I need to understand. On 1st April 2016, T acquires telephones for its sales force. Telephone. Unhone likha hi hai. Telephone, small personal tablets, small items of furniture, or any item which has value less than 5,000 will be treated as low value item. The terms of the lease require an initial payment of 2,000. Followed by 2 payments of 8,000 each on 31st March 2017, 31st March 2018. 2,000 you are paying now, and then you will pay 8,000 in December, March and March, 2 years. So in total, how much we will pay? 2,000 plus 8,000 plus 8,000, 18,000. This is more than 1 year, more than 12 months. But this is relating to telephone. और टेलीफोन का लाइफ कोई ऐसा एसेट्स नहीं है कि 2 साल 2.5 साल होगा. इवन दो वी आर गोइंग टू पे लीज पे ले रहे हैं, क्यों ले रहे हैं मेरे को समझ में नहीं आ रहा है, बट दे आर सेइंग दैट वी आर टेकिंग द टेलीफोन फॉर स्टाफ पर्पस ऑन लीज बेसिस. सो द इंपैक्ट ऑफ दीज लीज अरेंजमेंट, प्लीज सी हियर हाउ दे हैव रिटन. IFRS 16 लीज परमिट्स अ सिंप्लीफाइड ट्रीटमेंट फॉर एसेट्स विद अ लीज पीरियड ऑफ 12 मंथ्स और लेस और ऑफ लो वैल्यू. ऑल्दो द स्टैंडर्ड डज नॉट गिव अ न्यूमेरिकल डेफिनेशन ऑफ लो वैल्यू, it give example of types of assets that may be included, and this includes telephones. The simplified treatment allow the lease payments to be charged as an expense over the lease period, applying the accrual concept. Means what? You don't have to find out interest, present value, assets, liability, nothing. Whatever you are paying, that will be treated as an expense. But you are paying in different years, different amount. The expense will be treated always equally every year. In 2016 you were paying 2000, in 2017 you will pay 8000, and in 2018 you will pay 8000. Actually first year beginning you are paying 2000, first year end you will pay 8000, second year end you will pay 8000. total 18,000 you are paying in 2 years. So every year expenditure will be total by 29,000. You will say that lease rent expense account debit 9,000, not the actual amount you are paying. You will be showing the expense on the basis why they are doing 9/12. Year ending is December. Sorry. I thought that year ending is March, but the year ending is December. आप टोटल पैसा 2 साल के लिए पे कर रहे हैं तो हर साल का खर्चा माना जाएगा 9,000. करंट ईयर में अप्रैल से लेकर दिसंबर 9 महीने है, तो 9,000 एक साल का 9 महीना का 6750 आप दिसंबर में पे नहीं कर रहे हो, करोगे. सो यू विल बी सेइंग लीज रेंट अकाउंट डेबिट टू लीज लाइबिलिटी 6750. लीज रेंट पीएल में डेबिट होगा, 6750 यू आर नॉट पेइंग. देन नेक्स्ट ईयर फिर 3 महीना का लीज रेंट आप और लिखोगे, पूरा साल का ही लिखोगे. नेक्स्ट ईयर पूरे साल का लीज रेंट होगा 9,000. सो यू विल बी पासिंग लीज रेंट टू लीज पेएबल 9,000 नेक्स्ट ईयर ऑल्सो. फर्स्ट ईयर हाउ मच यू आर पेइंग? यू आर पेइंग 2,000 एट द बिगिनिंग एंड यू आर पेइंग 8,000 एट द एंड ऑफ फर्स्ट ईयर, 10,000. जबकि फर्स्ट ईयर आपका टोटल खर्चा कितना आ रहा है? ओनली 6750. अगेन आई एम गोइंग स्लो. वी आर सेइंग दैट इन टोटल इन 2 years, द 2 years इज नॉट मैचिंग विथ अकाउंटिंग ईयर एंडिंग. आवर अकाउंटिंग ईयर एंडिंग इज डिसंबर, बट वी विल बी मेकिंग पेमेंट ऑन मार्च, बट वी नीड टू प्रिपेयर अकाउंट फॉर द ईयर. इन टोटल 2 year वी आर गोइंग टू पे 18,000. सो एवरी ईयर द एक्सपेंस विल बी 9,000. इन शॉर्ट टर्म लीज और लो वैल्यू लीज देयर इज नो इंटरेस्ट कैलकुलेशन, there is no present value, there is no asset, nothing. You are taking the asset on rent, you will show rent as an expense. But the rent expense will be every year has to be seen. The total rent may be payment every time different, but you need to show the expense equally every year. So I teach total 18,000 by 29,000. You have taken the asset on 1st April. Now 1st April to 31st December is only 9 months. So in 1 year expense is 9,000. 9 months expense is 9,000 into 9/12, which is coming 6750. So you will be passing journal entry, lease rent account debit to lease payable 6750. But you have paid 2,000 at the beginning. So lease payable to bank 2,000 at the beginning. And then you paid 8,000 at the, no, you are not paying 8,000. You are paying 8,000 in March 2017. So your 6750 is the first year expense which you out of which you have paid 2,000 only. So in the first year there will be a liability in the balance sheet, 6750 minus 2,000, 5750, because you have not paid 5750. It is current only, because it is to be payable in the next year only. There is no concept of non-current in short term lease, only current. Now second year, that is 1st January 2017 to 31st December 2017. 9,000 is the expense. So lease rent account debit to lease payable 9,000. But you are paying 8,000 on 31st March 2017. So lease payable to bank 8,000. So earlier outstanding was 6750 minus 2,000, 4750 plus 9,000 minus 8,000, the second year end liability. Now you are going to the last year. Last year you will be using the assets for 9 months, 3 months, 12 months, then 9 months. So 9 months, sorry, 3 months, 9 months, 1 year and 3 months. So it is 9,000 into 3/12. Again, lease rent account debit to lease payable. And that you total pay at the end of 31st March 2018, whatever is the due. What will be the due? First year due amount was 6750 minus 2000, 4750. Second year due amount is 4750 plus 9 minus 8. 4750 plus 9000 minus 8000. So it is 5750. Third year, what will be the lease rent? 9000 into 3/12. Third year, what will be the lease rent? 9000 into 3/12. I think it will be coming 2250. So 5750 plus 2250. What is the total due? 5750 plus 2250, 8000. And you will pay 8000. One second. Hello? Upari to achi. হ্যাঁ ঠিক আছে, কোনো নিচেতে থাকুন, বলবো। হ্যাঁ 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 ঠিক আছে ঠিক আছে। সো ইন দ্য থার্ড ইয়ার আফটার থ্রি মান্থস ইউ উইল পে 8000, which is the due amount. There is no outstanding, there is nothing. There are two things you need to consider in your brain. First of all, in short term lease, in low value assets, no calculation. No present value, no interest, nothing. Whatever is the lease rent you are paying is an expense. The lease rent may be different year, but you need to show the lease rent equally every year. So if you are making less payment, it will be a lease liability. If you are making more payment, it will be treated as advance lease rent. But the expense will be coming in the PL account equal amount every year. And once the lease is over, liability and assets will be over. The expense in this period 6750 is not the same as the payment of 2000. So 4750 is outstanding at the end of first year. So a statement of PL 6750, and in the balance sheet there is a lease liability of 4750 for first year. Second year, again the expense will be 9000. The liability will be 5750. Because 9000 ke badle you are paying 8. Third year, the expense will be 2250, liability will be 0. Because you will pay total lease rent, whatever is outstanding. Are you getting? What is a short term lease? No calculation, just the short term lease. We need to always charge the lease rent payment as an expense. If the payment term and the year ending is not matching or the amount is different, there will be some outstanding. This whole thing was same in the IS 17. Jo bhi maine numerical discuss kiya hai, IS 17 mein current, non-current, assets, liability, then rent, everything same. Khali naam kya bolte the? Finance lease, operating lease. Abhi IFRS 16 mein kya bolte hai? Long-term lease, short-term lease. Pehle conditions tha. Finance lease hone ke liye there were conditions. Now the conditions are very short. Any lease which is not a short term lease is a long term lease. No condition for a long term. Short term kya hoga? Less than 12 months or low value assets. Examples of low value assets: table, furniture, telephone, small computers like that, laptop like that. Mid year into lease. Can you see the screen? C Limited entered into an agreement to lease an item of plant on 1st October 2018. We are taking the asset on lease on 1st October 2018. The lease required 4 annual payments of 2 lakh each commencing on 1st October 2018. So on the date of lease, we are making one payment. $2 lakh year end se nahi, beginning se. 4 times. First payment now and then further 3 payments in 3 years. The plant has a useful life of 4 years and is to be scrapped at the end of this period. Uska life 4 saal hi hai, 4 saal baad kharab ho jayega. But hum log ko matlab nahi hai, hum log to lease pe le rahe hain. The present value of the lease payment 7 lakh. The implicit rate is 10%. If I will say that they have not given 7 lakh. They have given 10% and we need to calculate 7 lakh. How we will do the calculation? If I will say that in the question 7 lakh is not given, they have given 10%, we need to calculate 7 lakh. How we will calculate? Saswat, why you are doing like that, man? Can we add the figures? The first calculation 10 10 15, have we added? Every figure is at a different point of time. You can't add them. The first 2 lakh is already now. So 2 lakh is already present value. The second 2 lakh is 2 lakh by 1.1. The third 2 lakh is 2 lakh by 1.1 square. The fourth 2 lakh is 2 lakh by 1.1 cube. Even though 4 figures, but everything will not be divided because first 2 lakh is already now. You are making payment of 2 lakh now. 2 lakh plus 2 lakh by 1.1 plus 2 lakh by 1.1 square plus 2 lakh by 1.1 cube. In the earlier questions, you were making payment at the end of the year. But in this question, you are making payment at the beginning of the year. So for that reason, first 2 lakh is already there. Second 2 lakh by 1.1. Third 2 lakh by 1.1 square. Fourth 2 lakh by 1.1 cube. Is everybody getting? For that reason, I asked. Then you will get 7 lakh. If you divide all 2 lakh, then in that case, it will be a wrong calculation. So you need to focus. Sometimes they will say that the payment will arise from the beginning only. Prepare extracts from the financial statement at the end of first year, 31st March 2019. Please understand that we have taken the asset on 1st October and the year ending is 31st March. The year ending is not matching with our date of leasing. The year ending is something different. October, November, December, January, February, March. So year ending is coming after 6 months. We have taken the assets on lease, not at the beginning of the year, but 6 months before the end of the year or after 6 months during the year. The calculations are all same, but there is some jhamela relating to years. Seven lakh divided by four will be the depreciation every year because that is the present value of assets. 7 lakh will be the lease liability at the beginning. But please understand that out of 7 lakh, we are paying 2 lakh on that day only. When we are taking the asset, humne loan ka 2 lakh usi din de diya. To humara 5 lakh hi bacha. 1st October, koi 7 lakh mein se 2 lakh humne de diya, to humara 5 lakh bacha. 5 lakh pe October se lekar March 6 mahina ka interest niklega. 5 lakh pe October se lekar March 6 mahina ka interest niklega. Even though saal ka interest hoga, but for the year, only 6 months are left. So at the end of first year, your outstanding is 5 lakh 25. Now, jab ab 1st April mein jayenge, to next 6 mahina ka interest aur niklega. 5 lakh ke upar, at the rate of 10%, for entire year, interest is 50,000. 25,000 of current year 6 months, 25,000 of next year 6 months. Aur fir ab next year, October mein 2 lakh aur pay karoge. तो 5 लाख 50 में से 2 लाख गया 350 बचा ये 350 के ऊपर फिर से नेक्स्ट ईयर 10% 6 महीना लाइक दैट इट विल बी गोइंग यू विल कैलकुलेट इंटरेस्ट फॉर 1 ईयर बट द करंट हाफ 6 मंथ्स यू विल बी सोइंग इन द करंट ईयर एंड नेक्स्ट हाफ 6 मंथ्स यू विल बी सोइंग इन द नेक्स्ट ईयर आर यू गेटिंग व्हाट आई एम सेइंग और व्हाट यू आर अंडरस्टैंडिंग हियर On 7 lakh, when you take the lease, you pay 2 lakh at that time only. So you don't have to pay interest on 2 lakh. 7 minus 2, 5 lakh. On 5 lakh, 1 year interest 10%, 50,000. But in the current year, there is 6 months. In the next year, there will be 6 months. So in the current year, half 25,000 interest. Next year, half 25,000 interest. And at the mid of next year, that is 1 year from now, you will pay 2 lakh. So at the end, mid of next year, there will be outstanding 3 lakh 50. On 3 lakh 50 at the rate of 10%, again next year interest. But 6 months will be for that year, 6 months for next year. Again, you will pay 2 lakh. That way the story will go on. The question is same. Just that the lease is not arising on the first day. The lease is arising after 6 months. So because of the monthly differences, there is some extra jhamela. Now at the end of first year balance sheet, what will be the total liability? at the end of first year balance sheet, what will be the total liability? That is on 31st March 2019. We took the asset on 1st October 2018. First year ending is 31st March 2019. So at 31st March 2019, what will be the total liability? I'm not asking current and non-current. I'm asking total liability. It is written 5,25,000. This 5,25,000 includes interest or not? This 5,25,000 includes interest or not? This time it includes interest of 6 months because we have not paid. This time it includes interest of 6 months because we have not paid. We will be paying in 1 year. And for the year, for current time, it is 6 months only. Now in 5,25,000, what will be current? What will be non-current? In 5,25,000, what will be current? What will be non-current? In 5,25,000, what will be the current liability? What will be the non-current liability? Out of 5,25,000, how much you will pay next year? Out of 5,25,000, how much you will pay next year? We are going to pay in 1st October 2019 2 lakh. So this 2 lakh is a current liability. This 2 lakh is a current liability. Can we say? This 2 lakh is a current liability. Can we say? Laddu. In this 2,25,000 second year 6 months interest is included. In this 2,25,000 second year interest is included. You cannot show the liability of second year interest in the first year. So out of 2,25,000 is interest. So principal is 1,75,000. So out of 5,25,000, 1,75,000 is current liability and balance non-current. We are paying this 2,25,000 last year interest, 25 current year interest, 50,000 interest and 1,50,000 principal. When first we paid 2 lakh, that was fully against principal. Second year 2 lakh, when we are paying 25,000 first 6 months interest, 25,000 second 6 months. 2 lakh includes 50,000 interest, balance 1,50,000 principal. But what I'm saying that this 2 lakh includes second year interest 25,000. Second year interest we are not showing in 5,25,000. So in 2,25,000 is deducted. The payment against first year interest and first year principal is 1,75,000 in second year. The payment against first year interest and first year principal is 1,75,000 in second year. Whatever is payment within a year is a current liability. And whatever is payment beyond a year is a non-current. So out of 2 lakh, excluding 25,000 second year interest, 1,75,000 relating to first year. So 1,75,000 is a current liability. 5,25,000 minus 1,75,000 is non-current. If you take 5,25,000 minus 3,50,000, that is also good. Oh, badhiya hai. Because seedha ho jayega. Lekin main yahan se soch raha tha. कि आपका 5,25,000 फर्स्ट ईयर के एंड में ड्यू है और सेकंड ईयर के एंड में देयर विल बी 3,50,000 ड्यू. सो वी कैन से दैट 5,25,000 माइनस 3,50,000. बट आप अगर इंटरेस्ट जोड़कर यहां पहुंचा देंगे तो गड़बड़ हो जाएगा. दे हैव स्टॉप्ड हियर ओनली. व्हाई? बिकॉज इन 3,50,000 दे हैव नॉट एडेड नेक्स्ट 6 months इंटरेस्ट. सो दिस 3,50,000 इज नॉट सेकंड ईयर ड्यू. दिस 3,50,000 सेकंड ईयर मिड ड्यू. दैट यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड परिता एंड एवरीबॉडी. आप ये सोच रहे हैं पहले वाला लॉजिक. बट दिस 3,50,000 इज नॉट सेकेंड ईयर एंडिंग. दिस 3,50,000 सेकेंड ईयर मिड. इफ यू गो इनटू सेकेंड ईयर एंडिंग इट विल बी इंक्लूडिंग सेकेंड ईयर इंटरेस्ट एंड यू कंसीडर दैट एज नॉन करेंट इट विल बी रॉन्ग. बिकॉज दूसरे साल का इंटरेस्ट इस साल लाइबिलिटी नहीं बनेगा. द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ सेकेंड ईयर विल बी द लाइबिलिटी इन द सेकेंड ईयर. इट विल नॉट बी लाइबिलिटी इन द फर्स्ट ईयर. So you can do 5,25,000 minus 3,50,000, but you need to understand it is not exactly same what we did earlier. Here we are standing 3,50,000 with the second year mid without adding the interest of the second year second half. Jisse ki garbad na ho. So 5,25,000 minus 3,50,000 is allowed. Is everybody is getting? सर देख के बहुत कुछ समझ में आता है, लेकिन अपने आप करने से ही 100% फीलिंग आती है, नया सम नहीं, यही सम्स। सो दे आर देइंग डेप्रिसिएशन 7 lakh by 4, फाइनेंस कॉस्ट 25,000 फॉर फर्स्ट ईयर 6 months, द नॉन करेंट एसेट्स 7 lakh minus 87,500, द नॉन करेंट लायबिलिटी 3 lakh 50, करेंट लायबिलिटी 1 lakh 75. Everybody is getting. We are going into chapter's last part, which I have not said anything since the previous day's class. Not said any single thing about this, because it can be explained only when everything is done. I have tuition center. Suppose I am the owner. I am not taken on lease. I am the owner. I want money for growth of my business, so I can sell my tuition center. If I will sell, I will get huge money for my growth of business. But the problem is that if I sell my tuition center, where I will continue my business? I will get the money, but I will not have the place to do the business. So what I did that, I contacted with a banks or financial institution. I told to them, I am selling my tuition center to you. The value is around 5 crore. They give me 5 crore. And I told them that now I am taking the tuition center from them on lease. So first I sold the asset. I got the money. That money I can use in the business, but I require the asset. So the person to whom I have sold the asset, I am telling to that person, I am taking the asset on lease from you. So for money, I am selling the asset, and for using the asset, I am taking the asset from that person as a lease. For that reason, it is called sale and lease back. The person to whom you are selling the asset, you are taking the asset from that person on lease. So it is called sale and lease back. The basic thing is that why this is done? For fund arrangement. So any organization has any assets, they require fund, they can arrange funds like that. They can sell the asset, they get the money, and the person to whom they are selling the asset, they can take the asset on lease from that person only. So they will have the asset, they will have the money, they can grow their business. Many organizations who have land, building and all that are there, they are doing this regularly for fund arrangements. Can I say that it's actually a loan taken by giving the asset security? Can I say that it's actually a loan taken by giving the security of assets? Because suppose if I will not do that, I went to a bank and I asked them for loan. They said that you need to give security of assets. I said, take my land and building as security. So they give me loan. So whether it should be treated as sale and lease back or whether it should be treated as loan, what should be the case? Whether it should be treated as sale and lease back or whether it should be treated as a loan by giving security of assets? It depends. If I am selling the asset, who will be the owner? Buyer? How can I say that I have sold the asset? All the rights relating to the assets transferred to the buyer. What is the rights? The major rights are, suppose aaj ke din mera property ka value 5 crore hai. Main lease pe assets le raha hoon further 20 saalon ke liye. I have sold it to the bank and I am taking the property on lease for further 20 years. 20 साल बाद प्रॉपर्टी की वैल्यू 5 करोड़ के बदले 15-20 करोड़ होगी. Who will be getting that gain? The increase in the value of the property, who will be taking? If the bank will be taking, then I will say that I have sold the asset. But if I am telling to the bank that whatever the increase in the value of the asset, I will be getting some part and all that, that means I have not sold that. That means I have taken the loan. We need to understand the nature, the contract agreement. Sometimes when you are taking loan and you provide the security of assets, it is not sale and lease back. you are giving the security of asset. Sometimes you are giving all the right of the asset to that person. And then you are taking on lease. Then it is called sale and lease back. In the first case, when you are giving the security and taking the loan, it is not coming here. The asset is yours only. You are taking the loan. You will show the loan as a liability. But in the second case, when you are selling the asset and then taking the lease, then we are coming here. We need to understand the contract agreement. Whether we have transferred the entire title relating to the asset to the buyer, then it is treated as sale and lease back. If we have not transferred the title, certain conditions are there, which says that actually we have not sold. So it will not be treated as sale and lease back. It will be treated as you have taken the loan by giving the security of assets. That's the most important part. That much detail, they may not be going into F7 or FR, but they will be going into SBR, strategic business reporting. Is level ka question aapko nahi pucha jayega, but phir bhi samajhne ki baat hai. Are you getting what I am saying? They are saying that transfer is not a sale. If the transfer is not a sale, then the seller, I am selling my tuition center, continues to recognize the asset in my balance sheet. I have not sold. And he will record the liability, that is the loan taken. I will be showing as a liability. That is not coming in this chapter actually. In simple term, the transfer proceeds are treated as a loan. The detailed accounting treatment for financial assets and financial liabilities covered in chapter 10. यहां पर बात ही नहीं हो रही, कुछ है नहीं उसके अंदर. मैंने एसेट्स को गिरवी रख के लोन लिया है, तो जो लोन लिया है जर्नल एंट्री बैंक अकाउंट डेबिट टू लोन एंड देन आई विल बी रीपेइंग द लोन अलोंग विद इंटरेस्ट. कुछ है नहीं, कहानी नहीं कुछ. इफ द ट्रांसफर डज क्वालिफाई एज अ सेल, देन द सेलर, दैट इज आई एम सेलिंग माय एसेट, मस्ट मेजर द राइट ऑफ यूज एसेट एज द प्रोपोर्शन ऑफ प्रीवियस कैरिंग अमाउंट दैट रिलेट्स टू द राइट ऑब्टेन्ड. इफ द ट्रांसफर डज क्वालिफाई एज अ सेल, देन द सेलर आई एम must measure the right to use the asset as the proportion of previous carrying amount that relates to rights obtained. I purchased my tuition center 11 years back. I gave the example. I paid around 1 crore. You can say that some repair and all that I did, that incurred expenditure of 25 lakh. So 11 years back, I incurred 1 crore or 25 lakh. 1 crore 25 lakh maine 11 saal pehle lagaya tha. 1 करोड़ 25 लाख पे मैं डेप्रिसिएशन कर रहा हूं ऑलरेडी 11 साल से हो रहा है. सपोज मेरे को एग्जैक्टली नहीं याद है, सपोज वैल्यू अभी 60 लाख है. सपोज द वैल्यू इज 60 लाख. दे आर सेइंग दैट इफ द ट्रांसफर डीड क्वालिफाई एज अ सेल, देन द सेलर लेजी मस्ट मेजर द राइट ऑफ यूज एसेट एज द प्रोपोर्शन ऑफ प्रीवियस कैरिंग अमाउंट दैट रिलेट्स टू द राइट्स ऑब्टेन्ड. मेरे को राइट टू यूज द एसेट इस केस में लीज का प्रेजेंट वैल्यू नहीं होएगा, वट एवर आई विल पे, इट विल बी द वैल्यू ऑफ द 60 लाख प्रोपोर्शनेट अमाउंट. इन द अर्लियर केसेस वी डिस्कस दैट प्रेजेंट वैल्यू ऑफ द पेमेंट विल बी ट्रीटेड एज एसेट वैल्यू एंड द लीज लायबिलिटी. हियर वी आर सेइंग दैट द एसेट वैल्यू विल बी बेस्ड ऑन 60 लाख. कैसे निकलेगा? दैट मींस दैट द सेलर लेजी विल रिकॉग्नाइज अ प्रॉफिट और लॉस बेस्ड ओनली ऑन द राइट ट्रांसफर्ड. इसके लिए मेरे को एग्जाम्पल में जाना होगा, मैं अपना फिगर के साथ एग्जाम्पल नहीं दे पा रहा हूं. On 1st January 2011, painting sells an item of masonry to college for its fair value of $3 million. On 1st January 2011, painting sells an item of masonry to college for its fair value of $3 million. The assets had a carrying value of $1.2 million for the sale. Maan lijiye mera property jo tha, उसका आज के दिन का वैल्यू 1.2 मिलियन है बुक्स में, बट आई एम सेलिंग इट फॉर 3 मिलियन. द सेल रिप्रेजेंट्स द सेटिस्फेक्शन. इफ देयर इज नथिंग, इफ यू आर सेलिंग एन एसेट ऑफ 1.2 मिलियन फॉर 3 मिलियन, वी कैन से 1.8 मिलियन इज द गेन. अगर मेरे पास अपना प्रॉपर्टी है 60 लाख का और मैं उसको 5 करोड़ में बेचता हूं, देन व्हाट विल बी द गेन? 5 करोड़ माइनस 60 लाख. बट हियर द गेन इज नॉट दैट. Here the gain is 3 lakh minus 1.2 is not that. Why? Because you are taking the asset on lease. The asset had a carrying value of 1.2 million prior to the sale. The sale represents the satisfaction of the performance obligation. That is, there is nothing which say that it is not a sale all rights given to the buyer. In accordance with IFRS 15, we have not studied that. Pertaining, painting enters into a contract with college for the right to use the asset for next 5 years. We have sold the asset, and now to the college we are saying that we will be using the asset for 5 years. So we are going in for lease. Annual payment $5 lakh are due at the end of each year. We will be paying $5 lakh 5 times. The interest rate implicit is 10%. We can calculate 5 lakh present value. But that is not treated as the right to use the asset. The present value of the annual lease payment they have calculated 1.919 lakh. The remaining useful life of the machine is much greater than the lease term. The remaining useful life of the lease is much greater than the lease term. We are going to use for 5 years, but the lease term is very, very far. Explain how painting will account for the transactions on 1st January 2011. They are only asking the journal entry on 1st January 2011. When you did that, when you sold the asset, when you take on lease, then what will be the accounting on 1st January? Actually, why they are not asking later one? Because later one is same as what we have discussed. Only the jhamela is there in respect of this one. हम लोग ये बोल रहे हैं कि जो लीज है जो पेमेंट करेंगे 5 साल उसका प्रेजेंट वैल्यू 1.9 मिलियन व्हाई वी आर सेलिंग द एसेट एट 3 मिलियन व्हेन द पेमेंट आई एम गोइंग टू मेक 19 लाख इन प्रेजेंट वैल्यू टर्म देन व्हाई आई एम एबल टू सेल द एसेट एट 30 लाख इज देयर एनी क्वेश्चन 5 साल जो मैं लीज रेंट पे करूंगा उसका प्रेजेंट वैल्यू 19 लाख है 19 लाख लेकिन एसेट को सेल करके आई एम गेटिंग 30 लाख व्हाई मैन 19 लाख इंक्लूड्स इंटरेस्ट 1.9 मिलियन 19 लाख इंक्लूड्स इंटरेस्ट डज इट इंक्लूड इंटरेस्ट Because it is present value. It does not include interest. 30 lakh is the value of the asset when? 30 lakh is the value of the asset when? 3 million 30 lakh is which date value? 30 lakh 3 million is which date value? $30 lakh So why in the lease, if you will say that 30 lakh is after 5 years, then I will say that interest. If both the figures are now, how the question of interest arises? You are going to pay lease for 5 years, but the asset will not be used only for 5 years. It will be used for more than 5 years. After 5 years, the college will be using the asset for any other purpose or whatever they will be doing. तो आपको केवल 5 साल का ही पैसा देना पड़ रहा है लेकिन एसेट का वैल्यू 5 साल का यूज का नहीं है ज्यादा है 30 लाख इज द वैल्यू फॉर मोर देन 5 years, मे बी 7, 8, 9, 10, 12, whatever. But 19 लाख इज द वैल्यू फॉर 5 years. They have not given you that balance life of the asset. But after 5 years, there is a huge life left. For that reason, you are able to sell at 30 lakh. Because if there is no further life after 5 years, why anybody will give you 30 lakh when the value of the asset is 19 lakh? Against 30 lakh, the book value is 12 lakh. Against 30 lakh, the book value is 12 lakh. So against 19 lakh, what is the book value? Against 30 lakh, the book value is 12 lakh. So against 19 lakh, what is the book value? Unitary method. 30 lakh ka value ka asset ke badle. Like if I will say about my center. 60 lakh is the asset value when the market value is 5 crore. 60 lakh is the asset value when the market value is 5 crore. I purchased the asset and all that 11 years back, 1.25 crore. Depreciation less करने के बाद आज के दिन 60 लाख है, लेकिन मार्केट में 5 करोड़ है. So 5 करोड़ का बुक में वैल्यू क्या है? 60 लाख. 3 करोड़ मार्केट वैल्यू का बुक में वैल्यू क्या है? 1.2. लेकिन मैं तो लीज में 1.9 करोड़ पे करूंगा ना, तो 1.9 करोड़ के बदले बुक वैल्यू कितना होगा? अगेंस्ट 3 करोड़ द बुक वैल्यू इज 1.2. सो अगेंस्ट 1.9 करोड़ द बुक वैल्यू इज हाउ मच? भाई यूनिटरी मेथड तो ठीक से लगा ले मेरे भाई. 30 लाख के बदले 12 लाख, 1 लाख के बदले 12 लाख बाई 30 लाख, 19 लाख के बदले कितना? 12 डिवाइडेड बाई 30, द होल थिंग इनटू 19. प्लीज डोंट डू नौटंकी. 30 लाख के बदले बुक वैल्यू इज 12 लाख. सो 1 लाख फेयर वैल्यू के बदले बुक वैल्यू इज 12 लाख बाई 30 लाख. फिर नौटंकी. और यू आर सेइंग 30. इफ यू आर डूइंग 3, इट इज 0.76. If you do 30, 12 and 19, it will be 7.6. ठीक है, चलेगा. We are saying that out of 1.2 million book value, 0.76 million book value relate to the lease period. Out of 1.2 million book value, 0.76 million book value relates to the lease period. Out of 1.2 million book value, 0.76 million book value relate to 5 years. Earlier, up till now, when we discussed, we said that the value of asset is 1.9. Whatever you pay, present value of that will be treated as value of the asset. But when you are going for sale and lease back, the proportionate book value will be treated as value of the asset. The proportionate book value is 0.76 million, or I will say 7,60,000, jo bhi aapko bolna ho. But it is not the same which we discussed earlier. Earlier we discussed present value of lease payment is the value of the asset. But in sale and lease back, the value of the asset will be the proportionate book value. This they were saying. The seller lesser will recognize the profit or no. If the transfer does qualify as a sale, the seller must measure the right to use the asset as proportion of the previous carrying amount. It is not the present value of lease payment will be the asset value. Proportion of the lease amount will be treated as the asset value. Are you getting up till now whatever I said? 19 lakh does not include interest. 30 lakh does not include interest. Against 30 lakh, the lease may you are paying 19 lakh. So against 30 lakh, the book value is 12 lakh. So against 19 lakh, what is the book value? $1.2 million is the book value. 0.76 million is the lease assets value. So what is the balance amount? 1.2 million is the total book value. 0.76 million is the lease value. So what is the balance? Indirectly, we are saying that 0.44 million book value assets we are selling. We are not selling 0.76 million. We are selling 0.44 million asset book value. We are not selling 0.76 million book value. At the same time, out of 3 million, 1.9 million each, actually, you are not, I mean to say, you are taking a loan. But balance 1.1 million, you are selling. So the gain will be 1.1 minus 0.44. To this, if I will show you with the answer, you will be able to understand better. Otherwise, the understanding will be slightly creating a problem. painting must remove the carrying amount of machine from, one second. Can you all see the screen? Painting must remove the carrying amount of the machine from its statement of financial position. It should instead recognize the right to use the asset, because now we have taken on lease. The right to use the asset will be measured as proportion of the carrying amount. Against 3 million fair value, 1.9 million is the lease fair value. So against 3 million, 1.2 million is the book value. So against 1.9 million lease fair value, what is the book value? Earlier we were treating 1.9 million is the asset value. Now we are saying proportionate book value is the asset value. We are getting cash 3 million by selling the asset. Right to use the asset will be 0.76 million. The machine 1.2 million gone, because we have given the machine, we have sold the machine. Lease liability is same as present value of lease payment, and the balance 0.66 million is the gain. The gain in PL is the proportion of the overall 1.8 million, that is 3 million minus 1.2, that relates to right transfer to college. This can be calculated as follows. 3 million. I will say that this calculation I am not liking. As I said, 1.1, 3 million, 3 minus 1.9. 1.1 is actually treated as sale. And the book value of that is 0.44. 1.1 minus 0.44 will give you 0.66 automatically. Even though in journal entry it is coming balancing figure, but if I will compare 1.1 minus 0.44, it will give you 0.66 balancing figure. We are not saying 3 million is a sale value. We are saying out of 3 million, 1.9 million is going into lease. That is not sold. 1.1 million is sold. That 1.1 million sold, compare with the book value of sale. Book value of sale is 0.44. So 1.1 minus 0.44. But it is not required to be calculated. Just, are you getting cash 3 million? We sold the asset, we get the 3 million everybody is getting. Are you getting right to use the asset 0.76 million? Because we take the asset on lease, so we are saying right to use the asset will be proportionate book value. The machine was there, we have already sold out. 1.2 million is gone. Machine is not there in the books. Then there is a lease liability. Present value is 1.9 million. Whatever is the difference will be the gain or loss. Whatever is the difference, that is the gain or loss, it is profit on sale of asset, 0.66 million. If we want to calculate this, then I am saying, what I am saying, the total book value was 1.2 million. Out of this 0.76 million, you are not selling. You are again getting on lease. So you are actually selling book value of how much? 1.2 minus 0.76, 0.44. Now 3 million you received. Out of 3 million, 1.9 million will be going under lease. So balance 1.1 million, you have actually sale realization. So 1.1 million minus book value sold 0.44 million will give you 0.66 million. 1.1 million sale value of other than lease minus book value other than lease 0.44. So 1.1 minus 0.44 will give you 0.66. ये लोग क्या कर रहे हैं? आपको 3 में से 1.9 million lease का है. तो 1.1 मिलियन का एसेट आपने बेचा है, 3 मिलियन के ऊपर आपका 1.8 मिलियन का गेन है. हाउ 1.8? 3 मिलियन यू आर गेटिंग अगेंस्ट बुक वैल्यू 1.2 मिलियन. सो 1.8 इज द टोटल गेन. 1.8 मिलियन इज अगेंस्ट 3 मिलियन, बट द सेल इज एक्चुअली 1.1 मिलियन ओनली. सो अगेंस्ट 1.1 मिलियन व्हाट इज यूनिटरी मेथड? दे आर डूइंग द कैलकुलेशन इन अ डिफरेंट वे व्हिच इज नॉट रॉन्ग. But I am saying that my sale is 1.1 million other than lease, and the book value of the asset sold is 0.44. So 1 minus 0.44 coming 0.66 million. Gain will be considered only on that part which is beyond leasing. because in leasing you are still going to use the asset on that part, no gain to be recognized. Gain need to be recognized only on that part which is other than leasing. Because even though you have sold the asset, but you have taken the asset on lease. So you will be recognizing the asset not as a machine right to use the asset, and you will be recognizing the gain only on the balance part. That the accounting is saying. Either you calculate 1.1 minus 0.44 or you do unitary method calculation. Against 3 million total fair value gain is 1.8. But against 1.1 million which is beyond leasing, what is the gain? In the chapter, first part is long-term lease. Whether there is leasing starting at the month beginning, year beginning, midday, you need to do the same calculation. Present value of all the payment, lease value, assets value, then you start paying the interest and principal. You need to show in the balance sheet current, non-current liability properly. Assets will be depreciated. If it is a short-term lease within 12 months, if it is very small value assets, maybe tables, furnitures, telephones, or a personal laptop, these types of things, maybe it is greater than 12 months, they will be treated as short-term lease. In short-term lease, there is no interest, there is no present value, nothing. You just need to charge lease rent in the PL account. But if the payment is different, you need to find out equal payment every year. That will be the expense. If you are paying more or less, that will be shown as a liability. Sale and lease back. You require funds, so you are selling the asset. But how you will do the business? You will take the asset on lease. But that will be treated as sale when all the rights relating to the asset transferred to the person. If you are not transferring the right, it will not be treated as sale. So whatever money you are taking, it is treated as loan against security of assets. So nothing is said in this chapter, that is loan accounting. But if you have sold, right transferred, and then you are taking the asset, the asset value is not the present value of lease. The asset value is the proportionate book value. And the income will be recognized only relating to that portion which is beyond the lease part. And then later on in this problem, 1.9 million is the value. On 1.9 million, there will be interest at the rate of 10% for first year. You will be paying the first installment. Then the first year outstanding. Second year again on interest and all that will be running like that, and you will be charging depreciation on 0.76 million for 5 years. 0.76 divided by 5. So later on what will be the accounting, there is no change, just that the initial, the asset value is not 1.9, the asset value is proportionate carrying value which was already there in the books. Why this entire thing has been done? Because in the world, airline companies or many companies, when they are using airlines, they were not showing them on the asset side. Because that was not treated as an asset operating lease. But now all airline company, all the aircraft, they have to show under lease right to use the asset, even though they are paying lease rent every udan, as I discussed. So the comparison will be meaningful when a company is taking the asset on lease and a company is purchasing the asset. Because earlier when the company was taking the asset on lease, not showing it as an asset. So the profit divided by asset in those companies where asset is purchased was coming lower. And in those companies where asset is taken on lease, coming very high. It looks like they are very good. Indian Airlines is continuously suffering losses. But if you analyze their financials earlier, you will find that they are giving good margin. So why that difference is there? That means there is a problem in accounting. This is already there in US GAAP for 10-15 years. It has been introduced in IFRS in 2017. And from 1st January 2019, all the organizations who are following IFRS, they required to follow. Aaj ke din abhi follow nahi karna hai. Pehle se aa chuka hai. 1st January 2019 se, jitni bhi companies IFRS ko follow karti hai, उनको ऐसे ही करना होगा. Now, when 2019 PL balance sheet they will prepare, They need to sow last year 2018 also. So even though in 2018 they have done the old treatment, but for comparison purpose, they need to prepare their accounts of 2018 also as per IFRS 16. Double accounting karna hoga. To bahut sari companyon ne kya kiya hai? 2018 mein hi IFRS follow karna chalu kar diya hai. Jisse ki IFRS 16, jisse ki they don't have to do it double accounting. That is practical aspects I am saying. But for exam purpose, they can ask any questions. Generally, sale and lease back portions, they don't ask in financial reporting F7. That they ask in SBR, strategic business reporting. But phir bhi aapke syllabus mein hai. Again, my advice, how to study. Whatever we have discussed in the class need to be done in writing again. Then do the test your understanding for. Small questions are there. Then do some questions from the exam paper. Then you will be feeling confident. Don't do the question straight away, new one, after just the class is over. Everybody, it's a request. Okay, if there is any doubt, we can discuss. Otherwise, we are leaving. Any question, any doubt, anything to ask? जो पुराना वाला recording आपको दिया गया है, उसमें sums करने में कोई problem नहीं है. Sums ऐसे ही होता था पहले भी और आज भी. खाली right to use the asset ये सब चीज change हुआ है. लेकिन मैंने उसके साथ इन वीडियो को भी ऐड कर दिए. ये वाला वीडियो भी ऐड कर देंगे. लेकिन आप टारगेट लेकर रिकॉर्डिंग करते रहिए जिससे कि आप एग्जाम प्रॉपरली दे पाए. ओके, थैंक यू. मैरी क्रिसमस टू ऑल ऑफ यू. एंजॉय, स्टडी हार्ड. थैंक यू.